I did programs and arranged it and got all the players and their bios and he's my guy.
Thank you all very, very much for coming. This is a very special day, bittersweet day. I think I don't want to say too much too because I think we're all feeling a lot of emotions. But we're here to celebrate the life of a very, very special woman and a mentor to everybody who is performing today. And we're choosing to probably to follow Doc's wishes of keeping the concert as concise as possible, so we probably won't say a whole lot, and we want music to speak for itself. But we'll be delighted to talk with you after the concert and share stories and all of those kinds of things. So again, welcome to everybody, and thank you all for coming.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. said anything about Karen, and I wanted to take an opportunity to just say a little bit. I certainly don't speak for all of them, and perhaps after the concert, you can have a moment to discuss her. As many of you know, Karen was quite a character who touched our lives, all of us, very deeply. She was a devoted person. And it's hard to imagine that someone with such a vital life force is not with us. Most days, I find myself thinking that I need to call her. And unfortunately, those days are gone. However, she left us all so very much. And I'm told that she wanted me to play this piece at her memorial. Like it or not, this piece will always be connected with her. And I hope everyone here had an opportunity to know her. She was one of the best friends you could ever wish for.
I'm also going to say just a few words. I'm the senior person on the program today. I didn't study with Karen the earliest, but I may have been born the earliest. So, some of you know that I recently also lost my mother, my birth mother, as well as this piano mother. And the similarities between this woman, I find striking. Not least the beautiful pictures we have of Karen. I said to somebody earlier, she looks so innocent, doesn't she? We all know better. She had a wicked sense of humor. She disliked sentiment in person. If she had met me today, she would have said, "Oh, great, you put on weight." True. My mother was the same. One of my nephews stood up and said that, I remember, surprising her one Christmas, and she said, "She didn't even say hello or Merry Christmas." She said, "You've put on weight." As you can tell, we are all fiercely devoted to Karen, as she was fiercely devoted to us. Sometimes fierce was literal, but so was devotion. One of the things we discovered with my mother going through her things, she was a woman who, like Karen, disliked public sentiment for the most part. She'd much rather have a funny Mother's Day card than a gooey one, if you will. She worked for a time editing in a magazine, and I just heard at her service that she was famous for having a red pencil and just crossing out paragraphs saying, "That's too syrupy." But we discovered in her things all kinds of sentimental mementos that she kept privately for herself. Early in my getting to know Karen, actually, while visiting here, her saying that when the time came and she passed on, the thing she wished for most at a memorial concert was Barbara Streisand to sing "Peter." Barbara wasn't available. And I'm certainly not going to try and do it. Karen was a woman of so much dream, wasn't she? The depth, the sass, and this wonderful tenderness. She loved the beautiful in music. She loved the virtuosic in music, and you'll hear more of that shortly at the end of the concert. I'll stop talking because you don't want to just hear me go on and on and on. But I hope that you sense the love that we all feel for her, and know that that's reflective of the love that we felt from her. Like Steve, I was so grateful to be able to phone her at any point in time to talk about a student, or about a piano piece, or about life, or about nothing. And we will all miss her. This is another piece, there's list, lots of lists. She was a list lover. Another piece she said many times that she wished to play at the memorial service. It's a little longer than Steve's, so be patient. Thank you.
what Dr. Gainsford failed to tell you was that there was a running audition going for that piece. And so every time one of Doc's students were to play that for a concert or something like that, she would always say, let's see if this one's good enough to be on the line. So, read one, the audition, and boy, did you do it justice. For us, the camaraderie that was the Shaw Studio was really something else. I can't think of any studio at IU anyway that shared the same kind of friendships that we've enjoyed over the years, and we still keep in touch with our colleagues, and you know, I consider these folks my close friends. And then there are other kinds of relationships that Doc certainly helped foster. If it weren't for Dr. Shaw, I wouldn't be married to my beautiful wife. And probably some of you don't know that Mark Dezwan and Jean Young have also been married for 1 year? 1 year soon, 2 years soon. So she was a matchmaker behind the scenes, I think. Well, I don't know what more to say that hasn't already been said, except to just share with you that a lot of the music that you've heard today are things that I know that she has requested over the years. And one of the last few conversations that I had with her was that she was reminiscing about various things, and she said, "I want you and me to play something with pizzazz." So we're giving her what she wants, and so those of you who are up in the balcony get the best view because there's a lot of shenanigans here. Sorry if we hit anybody in the first row. Don't worry, there's no smashing watermelons or anything like that. But hopefully this will end the concert on a high note, and you know, please go forward with nothing but fond memories of Dr. Shaw. I think her legacy will live on for a long, long time through her friends, through her students, anybody that knew her. And just a quick word, Sandra has requested that all of her students that played today and all of the students that have studied with her in the past, she'd like for us to come up and do a picture after the concert. And of course, there is a reception in the dining area after the concert. And I would probably be remiss if I did not tell you that, or remind you that we are a nonprofit organization and that your donations are always appreciated. Thank you all for coming. Thank you.
of all, and I hope that you will look at some of the things. I just quickly put all this together, but we did spend a lifetime as sisters and students and her career over there at Carnegie Hall and other places. So thank you for partaking, and I hope you enjoy the concert.